Measurement Unit Section 2, Metric System. The metric system is used worldwide. In 1977, there was a presidential proclamation that the United States would convert over to using the metric system. Well, we're not quite there yet. The metric system uses one basic unit of measurement for each physical quantity. If we're talking about length on the metric side, there's only one unit of measurement used, the meter. On the English side, however, we have all kinds of terms to describe length. The metric system is based on number 10, which allows for easy conversion among the different metric units, and bonus, no fractions. The base units in the metric system are the following. If we're measuring length, we use the term meter, and it's abbreviated with a lowercase m. If we're talking about mass or weight of something, we use the base unit gram, abbreviated g. If we're talking about volume or capacity of a container or object, we will use the base unit liter in the metric system, and abbreviated with L. To change the base of unit, for example, if we have a liter, we can see right away that if we just stay with a liter, and we're talking about the capacity of this silo here, there's a lot of liters. So to handle that, if we need a larger base, we're going to multiply our base unit by multiples of 10. We start with our liter, multiply it by 10, and that by 10, and that by 10, and so on. You can create them by multiplying by the base of 10 and identify each new larger unit by adding a prefix to the base to represent that multiple of 10. The prefix describes how much larger it is than the base unit. Here we have the liter again. If we multiply it by 10, 10 times the liter is going to be represented as a deciliter. If we take that deciliter and multiply it by 10, we will call it a hectoliter. Anytime we see hecto, it means it is 10 times 10 the liter, because we had 10 times the liter for deca and another 10 times 10 or 100 times the liter is the representation by the prefix hecto. Another multiple of 10 is going to be represented with the prefix kilo. We now have 10 times 10 times 10 or 1,000. Kilo is the prefix to represent 1,000. So the equivalencies are here. One deciliter, and this could be a gram or it could be a meter. The prefix means 10 times the base. If we're talking about hecto, that's the 100, 10 times 10. And if we have a kilo, in this case a kiloliter, amount of volume here, kilo prefix is replaced with equivalence or understanding of 1,000, 10 times 10 times 10. Common prefixes in the metric system are the ones we just saw. As our values are getting larger, going to the left, we have the deco and so on. If we're dealing with an example of length, the base unit is meter, and here we have a piston that has a diameter of 0.0889 meters. This would be the equivalent of saying that this diameter was a fraction of a mile. In the English side, we would convert this down to inches so that we could have a better understanding of what the measurement is. In the same context, we're going to do this in the metric system only by the use of prefixes. So if we're looking for smaller units of measurement and we cut the meter up into 10 pieces, 1/10 of a meter is a decimeter. In other words, it's going to take 10 decimeters to make 1 meter. If we take that decimeter and further cut it into 10 pieces, taking one of those 10 slices, we've diced it again by 10. That represents a centa prefix, which means it will take 10 centimeters to equal a decimeter. And because we take 10 decimeters to equal a meter, 10 times 10 means we need 100 centimeters to equal a meter. If we further dissect this into centimeter into 10 parts, the prefix to represent that is a millimeter. 1/10 of a centimeter is a millimeter, or 10 times 10 times 10, 1,000 millimeters are necessary to equal 1 meter. The prefix milli means 1,000th of a meter. So back to our common prefixes. As we go to the left, the prefixes are getting larger, the deca, hecto, kilo that we saw earlier. But if we need to go smaller, we'll go to the right. As you move to the right, they become smaller. Each one is 1/10 smaller than the previous one. There are two ways that we can make metric conversions. In this first example, we're going to use conversion fractions. The problem asks us to convert 1.5 meters to centimeters. So we start with the given information expressed as a fraction with a denominator of 1. We're going to look for the relationship between meters and centimeters to express it as a conversion factor fraction. We want to get rid of meters, so we'll put the meter fact in the denominator. And looking at our prefixes, it takes 10 centimeters times 10, or in other words, 100 centimeters to get to that base of 1 meter. So we have an equivalence of 1 meter to 100 centimeters, canceling out our common units then, and multiplying numerators together, we end up with an equivalence of 150 centimeters to the 1.5 meters. The second method is using a shortcut where, in this example, we're going to use the prefix chart to do our conversions. We have 3,200 grams that we want to convert to kilograms. So here's our conversion chart, which is in the middle column of your conversion table at the top. We are at the base unit. This is where we're starting. We're given grams, so we're going to start our focus there, and we're converting it to kilograms, which puts us out here on the far left-hand side of our prefix chart. Since each one of these prefixes represents a power of 10, deca is 10 times the base, hecto is 10 times deca, and so on, this equates with our decimal place values as well. So we're going to take the given measurement. The understanding is that the decimal place of any number, if it's not indicated, is to the right of the last number. We're going to move that decimal place the same number of powers of 10 that our prefixes represent to go from the given grams to the kilos. So we're going to move our decimal 1 for deca, 2 for hecto, 3 for kilo in the same direction on our number. So the decimal place is 1, 2, 3. The new place is between the 3 and the 2, which gives us the equivalence of our grams in kilograms, 3.2 kilograms. In this next example, they're asking us to convert 6,500 liters to milliliters. Liters is here our base unit. There's no prefix on it. We're going to milli, so this time we're moving it to the right. We're going to a smaller measurement using the prefix chart, and again, understanding that each one of these prefixes is a power of 10, which is equivalent to a decimal place. We'll count the number of decimal powers of 10 that we've moved. Not counting where we're starting. We have moved 1 to deci, 2 to centi, 3 powers of 10 to the right. We will mimic that same movement on our given number. We had 65 hundredths liters. We're going to move in the same direction, the same number of decimal places, 1, 2, 3. We don't have a third place. We'll indicate that third place with 0, a placeholder. We now have an equivalence to our original number by simply moving the decimal places that correspond with the powers represented by the prefixes. So 0.65 liters is equal to 650 milliliters. Here we have a third example. They're asking us to convert 850 centimeters to kilometers. Centa is the prefix, which tells us we're over here. This is our starting place. And we're going way to the end on the left-hand side to kilo or kilometers. Just as in the previous examples, we're going to count the number of prefixes, which is equivalent to powers of 10, which equates into decimal place movement when we convert these. So deci is 1, base is 2, dec is 3, hecto is 4, kilo is 5. We go in the same direction as the prefixes from where we start to where we end. We take our beginning number, which the decimal place is here on the left. We're going to move it 1 for deci to the left, a second for base, a third for deca, and we need to move 2 more places, 1 for hecto, 1 for kilo. And to do that, we need to put in 2 zeros for placeholders. So you can see we move that entire 5 decimal places from our original to give us an equivalent. On page 17, you'll find practice.